At the source location of a document, you can upload a PDF. And clicking on it will open up that PDF. Inside a PDF, you have editing options as well. You can drag your cursor over any text to highlight it, or you can use Control plus drag to create a highlighting box. Both of these methods can be saved as highlights. Highlights are referenced rem to your PDFs. Using Control plus C on any highlight, I can then paste it over into my notes. This will transcribe the PDF highlights into your notes. Alternatively, you can hit Enter to copy the rem as a pin to make a nameless reference. I'll go over pins a little later in this video. If you then close the PDF, clicking on the highlights in your document will open up the PDF and bring you to the part of the highlight in the actual article. After marking up a PDF, you also have the option to view all the highlights from that particular PDF. To do this, click the Notes button at the top left of the document, and the highlights will be organized by page. You can go back and forth between the highlights and the PDF by toggling this Notes button. Some metadata and even the author information can be copied from PDFs and pasted into your notes. For example, if a PDF has its outline laid out, you can extract this information into your notes. It doesn't work for all PDFs, but some of them will. By including a side document to take notes on, we've made it easy to generate your own interpretations and mental models for PDFs and articles, while still being able to reference the original content. This way, it's always easy to refresh your understanding or revisit a paper later on without losing your train of thought.